Hello friends, in this video I am going to deal about one of the common variety in mal presentation, that is the face presentation. So in this face presentation, the face is the presenting part which comes in relation with the internal os. Before I start with the cardinal movements, just have a look what are the conditions under which the fetus lies. So here lie is the longitudinal, presentation is the cephalic, presenting part is face, denominator is mentum, it is the bony fixed point which come in relation with the pelvic brim. Attitude is flexion of the limbs and there is a complete extension of head. So the occiput come in relation with the back, and there are four positions which are formed in the pelvic brim are: the first position is right mento posterior, in which the mentum is directed toward the right side of sacroiliac joint. Second position is left mento posterior, in which the mentum is directed toward the left sacroiliac joint. And the third, which is the commonest position in the mentum, is left mento anterior, in which mentum is directed toward the left side of iliopectinal eminence. And the fourth one is right mento anterior. So the mentum is directed toward the right side of iliopectinal eminence. So here I will show the mechanism on the anterior aspect, and the common position is left mento anterior, and these movements are similar as in the occipito anterior. So first step is engagement. The engaging diameter of fetal head is submento brygmatic. So it starts from below the mentum or chin till the brygma, and it is about 9.5 cm, and it engages in the right oblique diameter of pelvic brim. So engagement occurs. After engagement, there is descent, and descent is a continuous process which takes place throughout the labor, and it ends at the delivery of baby. Instead of flexion, there is increased extension. And after extension, the movement is internal rotation of mentum, and it rotates 1/8 of the circle and comes behind the symphysis pubis. But there is twist which occur in between the head and the shoulder, and the shoulder lies in the oblique diameter of pelvic brim. After internal rotation, the chin sweeps the subpubic arc, and the chin, face, brow, vertex, and then the occiput is borne by the movement of flexion instead of extension as in occipito anterior. After that, the restitution takes place, that is 1/8 of the circle rotation, in which the twist which was occur at the time of internal rotation of mentum is released here. After that, there is internal rotation of shoulder, and shoulder rotate 1/8 of the circle and comes behind symphysis pubis, and externally it is visible by the external rotation of head. Now the head and the shoulders are in the direct alignment. The anterior shoulder sweeps the subpubic arc, and the posterior shoulder escapes the perineum, and the rest of the body is borne by the movement of lateral flexion. So this mechanism takes place in the anterior position. Now comes the mechanism in mento posterior position, and in the mento posterior, the mechanism is same as in occipito posterior, and in that there are three condition occurs. The first condition is incomplete forward rotation, and the mentum rotate only 1/8 of the circle. Or it could be non-rotation, it means there is no rotation and it become arrested in that position only. And the third one is mal rotation, in which mentum rotate posteriorly and come in relation with the sacrum. And in all three condition, vaginal delivery cannot be possible. As in occipito posterior position, the face to pubis delivery would be possible. But here it cannot be possible because the length of neck is short, and the sacral hollow is about 12 cm long, and as the extension occurs, the thorax also thrusts in and it causes arrest in that position. So all these three conditions creates obstruction and the vaginal delivery is obscure. So here we learn the how mechanism takes place in manto anterior and manto posterior face presentation. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe our channel, like the video and click on bell button.